Thanks, folks. All right, we're halfway through day two. I hope you're all holding up. We've got a lightning talk here, so I'm going to move quickly. And today we're going to talk about zero trust security and the importance of identity-based security across applications, networks, and people. So HashiCorp helps companies standardize their cloud operating model for the shift to multi-cloud and modern data center environments. And we offer solutions that support that transition across infrastructure, security, networking, and application delivery. And in terms of who we serve, we're built on open source, and we see huge adoption across practitioners to standardize workflows for deploying infrastructure, secrets management, and service networking. But we're also becoming the go-to for zero trust security for enterprise solutions for some of the largest businesses across industries in the globe. And we went public back in 2021 to ensure we could continue to invest in that growth. So the number of breaches are increasing every year. I'm not going to spend much time here, but I wanted to say that, like, at the heart of these breaches, whether by accident or by bad actors, you know, humans are really at the heart of a lot of these breaches. And this speaks to the need for more automation in security. So starting with the context of why we're here, we're going to use this session to sort of reorient around zero trust security and what this next phase looks like for identity-based security. So it starts with that shift to the cloud, and the traditional approach was really much simpler. Everything was defined by a clear network perimeter. Things were static. Physical attributes, physical servers, clear network perimeter. We call this the castle and moat approach, where everything was controlled through a single point of entry, and all unauthorized traffic or access could be restricted or blocked. And in this model, there was this distinct binary of anything outside the network was bad, and anything inside the network was good, and had access to just about everything. But the method of securing based on clear perimeters and IPs really becomes more challenging in the cloud, as we know. Everything's dynamic, so there's no clear network perimeter. Infrastructure is continuously deployed. And without that trusted perimeter, there's no trusted method for access, and securing data really becomes more challenging. So you really can't trust anything and need to assume that there's already been a breach. So what happens when your apps in this infrastructure extend into multiple data centers or clouds, or you really don't own that data anymore? This shift from static to dynamic, as I mentioned, these old approaches start to fall apart. So whether you're migrating to a private cloud or multiple clouds, or you have some combination with an on-prem data center, in this modern data center world, you need this dynamic and ephemeral access, moving away from IP-based security. And so now we look at everything with a logical entity, where it's a web app or an engineer or a database or a load balancer. Everything has an identity that allows us to authenticate across platforms. So at HashiCorp, we really believe that zero trust security is predicated on identity. And to do this effectively, there's really four key pillars. When you combine all four, you can authenticate and authorize users and machines at all layers of dynamic network based on that identity. On the far right, the first concept is really around human identity. This ultimately boils down to single sign-on. So you have that common directory of all employees. You can identify, for example, like who's a database administrator. And then on the far side of the spectrum, which we're going to talk about first, is the concept of machine authentication and authorization. So we need that application identity and clearly define, like, what is a web server, what is an API. And once we identify those things, we can use that for secrets management so that a web server can get access to an API or token just in time. And then the second one is service networking. So this is, you know, ultimately having a control plane where we can define these central routing rules. Like, this API is allowed to talk to my web server. And then the third column we're going to dive into is human to machine access. So establishing which systems users can access based on identity and ensure session data is always secure. So we're going to dive a little deeper into all of these use cases. Ultimately, our philosophy is to trust nothing and authenticate and authorize everything. And that's really at the foundation of everything we do at HashiCorp around zero trust security. So as I mentioned, we're going to start with that machine-to-machine authentication and authorization use case. And the key principle here with Vault is our identity-based security product that is centered around secrets management and data encryption. So when we talk about secrets management, how do you centrally store and protect secrets across clouds and data centers? And this could be anything from tokens to passwords or credentials, encryption keys, like ultimately the list goes on and on. And so Vault becomes this identity broker across apps, networks, and people. Depending on how you're looking to implement, another thing that I want to call out is this idea of dynamic secrets, which is dynamically generating secrets that are accessed or requested and provided in just in time. And these are short-lived that can be automatically revoked or rotated as well. So this is really important so that you kind of take away that human element that we talked about is really at the core of so many breaches today. And you don't have to think about, you know, who controls it? How do you control how long a secret is supposed to live? How do you rotate? And then ultimately, this is, you know, that doesn't scale. And so that's a critical part of zero trust security. And then lastly is data encryption. So the idea of keeping your application data secure across your environments. So in the unfortunate event of a breach, you still ensure that your data is protected. So when we talk about Vault, it's worth mentioning the scale at which it's been adopted. Vault Kubernetes utility has been downloaded close to 9 million times over the last year. Vault open source has been downloaded over 131 million times. And we have hundreds of customers, including 70% of the top 20 US banks that use Vault. And when we talk about Vault, I introduced some of the core concepts, but I really wanted to reinforce this idea of identity brokering, so that Vault acts as that trusted identity broker, that it can pull from identities from different environments like cloud IAM systems or Kubernetes. And then within the system itself, it can create its own kind of version of an identity around applications and certain technologies. So that way you have an app that needs to talk to a database, the application can have an identity, the database has an identity, and ultimately that interoperability is much more seamless. So Vault's available on the HashiCorp Cloud Platform. So if you want to use Vault without the overhead of managing it, it abstracts away a lot of that complexity and around running the clusters. And ultimately, HashiCorp really offers the only zero trust solution that is delivered 100% in the cloud. Push button deployment, identity-based security solutions. We're gonna talk about a couple others and share a recent update that I'm excited to announce. So second, we're gonna look at machine-to-machine access with Consul. So this is centered around the idea of service networking across any cloud, and we're gonna deep dive a little bit into what that looks like. So there's really three primary areas that we think about around this service networking. First is service discovery and health monitoring. So this is a way that you can get a real-time network topology where everything is in the health of the different applications and services running across these environments. And then second is this multi-platform service mesh. So the idea of securing service-to-service traffic with mutual TLS and enabling encrypted traffic across the whole mesh. And then the third is network infrastructure automation. So this is the idea of automating all of your network-related tasks programmatically through code. So first use case is service mesh. Having this simplified service mesh across different environments, if you're talking about networking with Kubernetes or running these different services in the cloud, how can you connect these all securely with intention-based networking so that things can be restricted from getting access, or you can grant access so that service A can talk to service B and everything else is kind of restricted all based on that service identity. And then we have the idea of network infrastructure, so you can easily deploy, manage, and optimize network infrastructure all through code so that you can do all the things you're trying to do with your network layer, ultimately programmatically. So, and again, when we talk about that guiding principle here for Consul, it's really around the idea of that service-based networking. So you can kind of intentionally map out what can talk to what, ultimately, and then how and what cannot talk to other things to ensure that applications have access to the right databases and only the databases that they're authorized to access, and then protect the data that's being interconnected there. So similar to HCP Vault, HCP Consul is also available on the HashiCorp Cloud Platform. So you can try these services today. You can trial them for free. If you go to cloud.hashicorp.com, please, I encourage you to check it out for any of the use cases that we've talked about today. A quick overview of the concept of establishing user identity that we talked about around that control base of employees, for example. So this is a well-known problem. It's currently being solved based on where customers are in their journey into these multiple environments. So in the traditional sense, you know, you simply had like a username and password. That's kind of how the world operated. And then as companies started moving into more of like a private data center, single sign-on world, this is where you started to get more technologies like Active Directory or LDAP. And then as companies continue that journey into the cloud, then you see this more identity platforms like Okta, Ping, and IAM. So this problem's really kind of solved with these trusted identity platforms. Companies are actively using them here on the right-hand column. But now I want to talk about that final piece, the third column here around human-to-machine access. And how do you secure access for people within your organization who need access to really critical infrastructure in different workloads? So this is the announcement I'm excited to share today. So we just recently launched beta of Boundary on the HashiCorp Cloud Platform. This is our secure remote access solution that allows you to simply permit access for critical employees in the organization who need access to that backend infrastructure. And I'm going to talk about some of the things that differentiates this from some of the other access management solutions on the market today, centered around the idea of identity and dynamically serving access that is permitted. So just breaking down that sort of traditional access challenge, if I think about like a technical persona, like a DevOps engineer who needs access to infrastructure, and then ultimately we'll talk about how Boundary can improve upon this. A lot of orgs are using several different methods for managing access to hosts and services. This is really challenging when it's beyond their own network and that perimeter extends beyond the cloud into the cloud. So some of these traditional approaches like SSH, bastion hosts, VPNs require a ton of manual overhead. And then you have, once you're there, full access to everything, which is not going to scale in the cloud. Individuals may need to go through a set of firewall or IP-based controls. Network security policies around location-based security and network location or client or target, that really also breaks down in this ephemeral cloud environment. Really brittle, and ultimately, this all contributes to having to maintain configurations in access management solutions that also ultimately become brittle in a cloud environment. And all of this kind of contributes to credential sprawl ultimately, leading to a higher risk of a breach. So in a more dynamic workflow, what that can look like is with Boundary, the whole premise is that these access controls are really based on that identity and providing an easy way to allow access to applications and systems with fine-grained authorizations. So there's no SSH keys to manage, no VPN credentials, simplifies onboarding immensely, and also reduces the risk of a breach as well. So HashiCorp Boundary, ultimately, our North Star in designing this was to automate key portions of the access workflow so that organizations can really improve their security posture, but not impede developer productivity. So you don't want developers to have to think about, you know, end IP addresses or ports they want to connect to. And the core idea is once you've authenticated and authorized to Boundary, we automate a lot of this so that the network remains private and credentials are never exposed. Ultimately, Boundary becomes that front door and is an identity-aware proxy for connecting to this infrastructure. So first we integrate with leading IDPs to enable authentication into Boundary. And once we've delegated that authentication to that external provider, the core idea within Boundary is that you can allow those fine-grained authorizations to the infrastructure and lock down services and actions that people can take based on their role. So then, in the second step down here, Boundary really streamlines connection to hosts and targets by automating service discovery and access configuration as those ephemeral workflows are deployed or changed. So the way that we do this is through dynamic host catalogs where we integrate with whatever, you know, a service registry that you use. Today we support AWS and Azure. We'll be expanding integrations here over time. And ultimately at runtime via an API, Boundary does a lookup of new targets. And this is what is really streamlining that critical access and ensuring that those ephemeral targets are always up to date for what people are authorized to access. And then the last piece around access is offering that just-in-time access to resources in a couple of ways. I mentioned that Boundary serves as a proxy, ultimately, and to establish that just-in-time network access to a client. And then that session is live and is only allowed to exist for a certain amount of time. And the other is integrating with secrets management solution of choice, like Vault, to broker those credentials to critical infrastructure so that credentials are never exposed. So on the right-hand side, with only a couple minutes left, I wanted to call out a common deployment methodology for HCP Boundary, where ultimately we will host Boundary for you. The control plane ultimately manages all state around what targets and users under management and access policies, as well as the external providers that Boundary can go to for service discovery. And then when a user authenticates that control plane and they go to connect to a target, the control plane assigns a worker node. And that worker node is ultimately a TCP-based proxy, can run anything on top of TCP like SSH, RDP, databases and so on, and really manages access for those types of sessions. And we call that a self-managed worker, where you have that worker in your own data center or cloud environment, and that controls the communication. And so this allows you to not have to have agents installed on these numerous targets that is really hard to manage over time. So that kind of summarizes the Zero Trust security solution with Vault as that identity broker for securing networks, applications, and people based on identity. Ultimately, I just want to say thank you all for taking the time to visit with us. Our booth is right over there. We would love to chat more with you and show you demos of Vault, Consul, and Boundary. And we've got like 1 minute left, so any questions?